This is an introduction to public health surveillance. Surveillance is defined by the World Health Organization as the continuous, systematic collection, analysis, and interpretation of health-related data needed to plan, implement, and evaluate public health practice. That's a long definition, but it's basically the ongoing and systematic collection of data to inform public health action. The purpose of this video is to introduce you to four main sources of surveillance data: disease reporting systems, health surveys, environmental monitoring data, and routinely collected administrative data. Among our disease reporting systems is our notification system. In this system, healthcare providers, private doctors, hospitals, laboratories, are required by law to report when they encounter patients with certain health conditions to a higher administrative level, like the county health department. When the data are received, on a monthly or even weekly basis, they can be compiled and analyzed to identify possible outbreaks. The conditions that healthcare providers are required to report, called notifiable conditions, are mostly infectious diseases, like measles, hepatitis C, or syphilis, but there are others too. The list of notifiable conditions varies across states and changes each year. I'll leave it to you to look up what the national notifiable conditions are on the CDC website. Registries are another disease reporting system that involves recording all cases of a particular condition in a specific population. The California Cancer Registry, for example, collects information on all the cases of cancer diagnosed throughout the state of California. Other states have registries that capture all cases of birth defects, autism, or survivors of the 9/11 attacks on the World Trade Center. Registries collect detailed information so that health practitioners and researchers can track people over time. Disease reporting systems are an important part of public health surveillance, but we also use surveys so we know what's going on not just with diseases, but also health behaviors. Surveys are designed to collect data on a representative sample of the population. If you've heard statistics on how the prevalence of smoking has changed, or what percent of the U.S. population is overweight, those are based on survey data, usually involving questionnaires or interviews, sometimes a physical examination. Some of the most well-known surveys in the U.S., the ones that give us estimates of smoking and obesity prevalence, are the Behavioral Risk Factor Surveillance System, or BRFSS, the National Health Interview Survey, NHIS, and the National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey, or NHANES. Besides disease reporting systems and health surveys, environmental monitoring is another important source of health-related information. Cities, counties, and states regularly monitor water for bacterial and chemical contaminants, and the air for pollutants. And finally, routinely collected administrative data turn out to be really important for public health surveillance too. The most important of these may be vital statistics or records of births and deaths. These are recorded at a local level, but compiled at state and national levels, so we know, for example, what are the leading causes of death in the U.S., how are death rates for specific conditions changing over time? Other routinely collected administrative data include physician or hospital records, which we can use to tell us what people are going to the doctor or the ER for. Or payer systems like Medicare, which include the electronic records of billing and payment for healthcare services. Laws and regulations are also informative, for example, those related to drug use. And finally, records of financial transactions or sales receipts, which can tell us a lot about how much and what kinds of tobacco products or pharmaceuticals are being purchased. We'll be thinking about some of the limitations of these sources next, and we'll also explore some other concepts, like passive and active surveillance, sentinel surveillance, and syndromic surveillance. But these four categories are a useful way to think about our public health surveillance. So next time you see a headline in the paper, you should be able to guess where those surveillance data probably came from, and maybe even whether it's worth the headline.